Yes. It was a beautiful day. It's gonna be a beautiful night. Break out the champagne.
Oh, it's recording now. So hey everybody, this is Joey and my featured guest, Michelle. Are we best friends?
Yes.
We are best friends.
You didn't know that.
I don't know if I should like give us that title.
Of course we're best friends. I mean, we check in everywhere together. People probably already figured that out.
I think we are. I mean, it's a very strange relationship. This is my house. My world. And yes. Anyway, we are here to discuss something.
What did you call
really
me
important.
The video? Did you what? Which name did you go by? Did
Michelle.
You say Michelle? Okay. Just want to make sure because you know.
But yeah, I'll call her Michelle. Her real name is Shanika, but I don't like Shanika. Never have.
You don't like the first
anyway, we are here to discuss something very, very important for this Tuesday.
No, it's something okay. That, this is all extreme.
Okay. Something that we have been struggling with. How long have we known each other? Anymore?
A couple of years, like
at least four.
Yeah,
maybe four years. But we have been struggling with something for a long time. And what have we been struggling with?
Our weight.
We have had some extremes. When we met, we were both like
morbidly obese.
I was 200. I know it was like 257 pounds.
And I was 242. You didn't know that?
I could never tell because you don't look like you. Even when you were at your biggest, you didn't look like it. But yeah, I mean,
everybody says that.
We were huge. We were really, really big. Anyway, we're huge. And then we start working out and stuff. Because our company had a gym membership when we were working together. So we had corporate membership at Peak before they went out of business. And we were working out there and we were doing really good. And then we lost a lot of weight in 2008. And then I stopped working there and went another way. And she went another way. And we hadn't talked like in a year. And then when we saw each other, we were both huge.
Again.
Really, really big together. Again. So that was, that was like 6 months ago too.
Yep.
And then
it was.
Yeah, and then like after 6 months we both start working out again. We both have our ways of working out and dieting.
And are you wanting to be candid and honest in this video or no?
No.
Okay. I just want to make sure. And you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, right? Exactly. Okay. But we're gonna have to share everything with everybody.
But
there's nothing
the
bad
thing.
Though.
Okay. Sorry, that was none of your business.
Who knows? But yeah, we went through a lot of extremes. Like, we were really bad. We were like, we were not eating. Fast. And my extreme was like working out hard. We don't even clap the same when we live in that
champagne. 5 miles every day.
Yeah, I mean, but it was good. It's exhausting of it. Oh, it's a party. And I think I found I work out like crazy and I stop eating so much. I'm like, what's your
I think what works for me is no carbs and no sugar. Okay? Because my body does not break down sugar at all. And you know sugar turns fat. But I think there are different diets for different people, and what works for you may not necessarily work for others. Yeah, I know. And so I feel like no sugar, no carbs, and I know that sounds unrealistic because, you have carbs in almost everything you eat, but if you can do low carb, like less than 20 grams a day, then that would definitely work. I've done fast, like I've tried a 21-day water fast. I usually only make it to 13 days. I don't know. That's like a magic number. After 13 days, it's a wrap. And I always break my fast.
That is so dangerous.
He thinks it's dangerous, but it's not. So just Google it, and you'll see that it's nothing wrong with not eating for 20
days.
Well,
it is for me, because I can't go without a day or I'll be sick.
But if you're drinking water, a lot of water, and you take multivitamins, multivitamins gives you all the minerals and nutrients that you need.
I know, but I mean, that's just, like you said, different body types.
He feels himself working out. I don't want to have to do that. And anyway, I used to work out a lot, and I wasn't losing weight like I used to do.
Different body types.
Yeah, and I mean, what else have I done? Okay, so I've done 1 day water fast. Okay, I've done a raw food diet.
Yes, yeah, I mean, you went big time raw food. How much money did you spend on
that? That was the thing. They had to get all organic and natural, whole foods and things like that.
Did you do like no carbs?
Honestly, yeah, I gotta stay as fly.
Yeah,
I did the Atkins diet. I did so many different diets. Like, I can't even think of. I've tried Weight Loss pills.
Okay, we're talking about diets, but I mean, clearly we have reached a milestone because right now I'm at 185.
And I'm at 189.
I mean, we've lost over 50 pounds in the effort. So, I mean, clearly I've broken through like all kinds of areas because right now I'm in a small t-shirt and a size 13. Unbelievable for me. But what's been our secret? I mean, what? Clearly we found something that actually works. So.
I think that because if you keep trying every different thing and you're really persistent, eventually you're going to find your niche. You're going to find what works for you because there are people who are advertising this and that and that and this, and then you try it and you don't reap the same benefits or get the same results that person gets. And then you're frustrated and you're upset and, you know, you get depressed and, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So if you keep just trying different things, you have to find what works for you.
And tore it up. Then we went and got like those cookies.
Yeah.
We couldn't get one cookie. We got like, yeah, self light by 15 or something.
It was
crazy. It was insane. We came back with like 9 cookies
and a whole big plate of ice.
Chinese food galore. It was crazy. But after that, though, you're right, though, because you know what? I ate all of that. I don't think I ate for like the rest of that night and clear until mid-Saturday or something. You know what? I just kind of turned it around. So, maybe that is super, because I know I eat really, really good throughout the weekend. I'll treat myself on the weekend. But then I'll check back on
Monday.
Yeah.
Monday through Friday. Right. That's how I think we should do it. I think we should eat super, super healthy Monday through Friday, and then on the weekends just like eat what we
right
eat.
But don't get crazy with it though, because if you go too far we might go back. And
some people don't care. Like, you know what I don't get? I'm not trying to be funny, because to each his own, and I, with all due respect, but like people who are like girls who are big, like plus size, and they embrace it. They're like, I'm plus size and what is it called, I'm plus size and loving it, or big and beautiful. And I wish I could be like that, but I don't even want to go to the beach because I think this is totally inappropriate. Like, for me to be out there at the beach, you know what I mean? Like, you don't have to be skinny, I just don't understand. Like, it's not, and you cannot say it's confidence. It's not confidence. I feel like they're complacent and they're settling and they've grown to it.
Yeah, I think they're almost in a sense of denial too.
Yeah, it's like, I'm gonna embrace my curves.
And it's just not for like women. I'm saying it's for everybody. Like, oh, I don't mind being fat or whatever. And I don't know. I'm not saying you have to go out and get skinny or anything.
You don't have to be like a size 2, but you need to be healthy.
Yeah,
be
care about yourself and be healthy.
And it's just like you won't be uncomfortable. You can breathe. You're more like flexible. You know what I mean?
Right.
You can buy different.
Oh my gosh. See, I mean, don't you feel so much better like when you walk in? I mean, yes. I just came back from the mall and I walked that mall up and down. I mean, and then went to some other shops, H.H. Gregg and some other places outside the mall. I mean, but I was out for a good 3-4 hours and I was having a good time. I wasn't tired. I remember anything that could as a result, you know, of losing all that weight.
Well, this is just part one. We're going to come back with part two because we've already recorded for 10 minutes. And Joey's about to go.
Yeah,
and
I tried to cut it off for 10 minutes. I'm about to go see Green Lantern.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, anyway, Joey's going to go to the movies.
Are you going to go? You want to go? It's 3D.
No.
You don't like Green
Lantern? I like these too.
Weekend.
Yeah, it's Friday night.
Anyway.
I didn't eat Monday through Friday because I was on a fast.
She really did. At all. We're having lunch and she was having water. And
that's what you gotta do. Yeah. Look at it like this. It's a temporary sacrifice to get to a greater gain. You're sacrificing temporarily. And anyway, being fit feels way better than anything could possibly taste. When you are, you know, fit and toned and in shape, like that is the best feeling of the world.
It
There's
really
nothing
is.
That tastes that good. You're when you taste something, you feel good about it in that
it's
moment.
It's temporary. Oh my gosh,
right.
Yes. And that's another thing. That's like the approach I've taken to cook. My mom's like, well, why don't you, because they had Doug Saws. I'm about to ramble because I do have a lot in my box. But they had Doug Saws. It's like a barbecue place where people don't know, like barbecue, cornbread, all this stuff. And they went out and got it. And I drove them out there to go get it. And she's like, well, aren't you going to get anything? I said, mm-mm. She's like, well, how can you sit in the car and smell it? You are so vain. Way more than I am. No, I was like, well, I took the
I'm
approach.
I'm listening to you.
Oh,
I hear exactly all
okay.
of everything you're
okay,
saying.
Okay, don't make me forget. But I told her I took the approach that I don't look at food as like something. I don't look at food as enjoyment anymore. You know, I'll go ride a bike, I'll go skate, or I'll go running for enjoyment. I look at food as complete nourishment. So, I don't know. That's,
and fuel for your body.
Yeah, I mean, I don't like look at it or, you know, I don't sit down in front of the TV and eat because I used to equate TV and food.
And that's one struggle that I have right now. I do not want to go to the movies if I can't handle popcorn.
Oh, wow.
That's what I'm saying. I don't. It's a struggle.
It's a mental.
It's a mental thing, but it's obstacles that you have to overcome. Even sitting at home watching a DVD, I'm like feeling like I need a snack.
Yeah.
Like,
I mean,
what a snack said, what
water.
A snack said.
Have some water.
Or you can have healthy snacks.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, exactly. Because I eat almonds. I love almonds, cranberries, and tuna.
And cashews.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. And cashews, yeah. But let's cut this off because it's 13 minutes.
All right, bye, guys. All right. Peace.